Hey, welcome to the DVB channel, and today we do have a final game for you, and it will be the Blue Impedramon against the Black Omimon Turbo deck. And we shall see how the game will go, as the blue player do go first in this game, evolving to the Electmon, and then evolving to the Colamon, the one cost blocker, passing back only one memory to the black player. Now the black player will evolve to the Commandramon here, and thus go for the Sealdramon for two costs, passing back only one memory to the blue player once again. The blue player will move up the blocker, calling an Electmon to pass back another one memory. Man, this memory control game is getting a bit fast. And the blue player will actually hatch its nursery once again. And thus go for the Vmon here, which is the best rookie in the game, in my opinion. And now he does go for the Hammer Spark here, pushing in the 3 memory, allowing him to actually evolve to the Dino Vmon. And he does choose to swing. He does have jamming, and he does hit into the Alter S. Man, that jamming really works, and he does evolve to the Goelamon for one cost and passing back only one memory to the black player. Now the black player do have one memory, but he does have a level 5. We shall see how the game will go. He does choose to evolve to the Numemon there, and going for the Metagurumon release in set 5, which just has the Digivolve skill to actually kill off a level 6 of 6 cost hardcore cost below, and if you do not, you can actually kill off the security instead. And now he does swing the Goelamon, hitting to the Zord there, so the Goelamon does die. Dino Beamon will start swinging at the security once again, jamming skill. And looks like he does have Impodramon in hand. With the 3 memory he have, he does evolve it. Now he does stand and does swing again once again, killing off, only leaving one security left for the black player, and go for another Hammer Spark, calling the Gomamon. Now the black player does have only one memory to work with once again. And he does decide to use the Metagurumon with the Inherit Baby skill to kill off, to actually trade off with the Impodramon. Very unfortunate for the black player, as the Metagurumon did not actually achieve anything yet, aside killing from a rookie. So the blue player does hardcore another Gomamon here, and hardcalling a Vmon to pass back one memory, and he does have 4 Digimon on his side of the field. And this is probably like the 7-6 time I have seen one memory pass back to the black player, and this is very unfortunate. And the black player doesn't seem to have any much move to make, given he has only one memory, and does decide to concede. Now that'll be 1-0 for the Impodramon, and the Impodramon will go first in this game, hatching to Demi Vmon, evolving to the Vmon here from BTO2. Now that's good for the Devi straight up, looking at top 3, refusing an Electmon and an Impodramon. Does opt for the Impodramon here. The black player turn and have 4 memory to work with, evolving to the Chumon here, and evolving to the Dark Tyranomon for one cost. Does decide to evolve to the Infomon for 3 costs in the nursery, and hard calling a Chumon to pass back 3 memory just nice to the blue player, as he does have Davis. And looks like he does go for another Davis here, revealing top 3, and we do see Pildramon, which is the only target he can take. And the one memory is seen here once again for the black player. Man, this black player must be really traumatized with this memory control game that the blue player is able to put up with. So he does hardcore the Gomamon here, and going for a Takumi. Damn, another one memory again to the black player. This black player have not seen any memory pass 2 yet. He does go for the Metagurumon here once again, the Digibus 2 to kill off that Vmon. And how will the blue player actually react to this? He does hatch to another Demi Vmon here, evolving to a Vmon. And now he does go for the Goelamon here for one cost. And finally going for the Pildramon, passing back yet again another one memory. But the Toy Agumon for the black player does activate, allowing him to draw one additional card as there's no swing. And swing with the Metagurumon, which is 12k. And does hardcore the level 5 for 5 memory. And does give 4 memory to the blue player, and the Metaguru does have reboot to restand. And the Pildramon will be pushed out, doing some incoming damage with the jamming first, and now evolving to the Impodramon to restand, and does have 2 more attacks on the Pildramon. And the black player only have a Dark Tyranomon to actually protect it, and the Impodramon is actually 12k DP, so he can easily hit over it, and he hardcore Gomamon to pass back that one memory again to the black player. Man, and the black player is forced to throw that Metagurumon at the Impodramon once again, and does evolve to the Hyandromon, but because of the Devis, he does get the 3 memory here. And the blue player seems to have a very very good game this game, evolving to the Vmon first, and evolving to the Colamon for 1 cost. And does go for another Pildramon in the nursery, passing back the 1 memory again to the black player, a much needed deja vu, and the black player seems to have a very hard time to decide what's the next move or what's the better move for him. So there's a fast forward here. Let's go for the Dark Tyranumon in the end for one cost, going for a common Dromon in nursery due to the top deck, and let's go for the Zwart here to actually activate his skill to mill the top 3 and do call 2 blockers, I think. Yes, so he does call the 2 blockers to actually block off the incoming threat from the blue player, and the pure Dromon will be brought out again, swing at the security, and there will be no guarding here. He's going to go for another input Dromon here, and because of the Vimon and the Takumi, he's able to draw a total of 3 cards upon their evolution. Man, that synergy is too sick. And he's able to swing twice with the Pure Dromon skill. And the last swing from the input Dromon will be forced to block from the Dark Tyranumon, evolving to the Goelamon here. And Goelamon does have 6k DP and is forced to trade with the Steel Dromon. And we do see another Goelamon here, which will hit over the Dark Tyranumon. So very unfortunate for the black player. And that's hardcore Agumon to give back yet again that one memory. Man, this game is so harsh for the black player for having no Tamer to set up. So he does use the Zwart skill to actually kill off that Agumon and swinging at the Impidromon to kill it off with 15k DP. And that's hardcore the Infernomon, or rather Infernomon, sorry, to actually de-evolve that Gorillamon, because Gorillamon can hit over that Black Tyranomon. Now, but the game seems to be settled here, because he does have 6 memory to work with, and he's able to come up with something. He does use the Gomamon to actually swing first. But looks like he does have Lobomon, which can evolve from the Devis, and this is game. Concluding the game with 2-0. Now we do finally move on to the deck list, and this is the exact same deck list that appeared in the final in my last week video. Starting off the level 6, we do have 4 Impidromons, and this deck is after all Impidromon deck, and I do not hesitate to say, you do still want to play the Omimon in this deck, and I definitely feel there is space for him. And we do more the level 5s, which are the 4 Dino Beamon and the 4 Pildramon. Now these cards are actually there for the jamming mainly, and of course the cheap cost evolution for the Impidromon, because you do not want to actually pay 5 memory for the evolution. 3 memory is actually decent because you do play Devis, and Devis does guarantee you 3 memory. Now moving on to the level 4s, he does play 4 XV Dramon. And this card actually has fallen quite a bit off in my opinion, because enemy do always have blockers set up, and especially now that all 6 colors have 2 different kind of blockers, so we actually can see some sort of card here. But the 4 Gorillamon here is super good, and I super recommend it. As you can see from the previous game, the Gorillamon is actually able to hit over that 5k blockers, which is going to be very common and will be run in most decks. Now we do move on to the blockers, and he does instead playing off Grislimon. He does go for the Coldramon, which is the one cost blocker, and it does make sense because you do eventually want to go to level 5, and Impidromon is actually a very aggressive deck. Now to actually end off the level 4s, we do have 2 Lobomon here, and Lobomon is super welcome in an aggressive team deck, because they are actually extra bodies that you can put out, and they are technically spear attackers. Without having summoning signals, you can swing for the game instantly, and especially you do have Heaven Spark to play with, so you will definitely have memory to play towards this card. Now we do move on to the level 3s here, and we do play 8 Vmon here. Now, Vmons are super strong in an Impidromon deck, especially the 4 jamming ones and the 4 restanding ones. The restanding ones do synergize well with the Impidromon skill, and will synergize even better if you do play Omimon, because Omimon does restand during the evolution, and you're able to swing once again, and allowing you to draw one. Now to actually end off the rookie count, we do have 6 vanilla rookies, and if you have not watched the game previously, these damn rookies actually memory controlled the hell out of the black player because of their 2 costs, and they do allow you to actually evolve to the Gorillamon in the next turn. So they are super strong and super undervalued, and I would dare say blue is one of the better colors to play so many vanilla rookies because of how the deck actually works, especially with the Hammer Spark. Now we do move on to the options, and I do mention Hammer Spark quite a lot, and Hammer Spark is such a super strong card since starter deck came out. Now this card does have a security effect of gaining 2 memory, so it's actually a defensive option to actually see in a security against the opponent. And we do end off the deck with 6 Tamers, 4 Devis, and 2 Takumis. Now Devis is quite straightforward, it's a 3 memory guaranteed Tamer, and you can search for a green Digimon and a blue Digimon on the top 3. Mainly to search out that Impidromon and other pieces that you need, And if you do happen to see a Dino Beamon, it's actually effectively a plus one. Now, the two Takumis there, it does help the deck a lot, I would say, because you are able to draw additional cards. Although it does kind of conflict against their Vmon swing, but this will definitely depend on the player. The player will actually have to think ahead and will want to decide whether to actually commit the Takumi early. If you do commit the Takumi early, you don't swing with your Vmon because you do lose memory. But then again, with that memory loss, you actually can control your opponent as well, giving back them only one memory. Now to end off this whole deck, we do have 5 Digitimers, 4 Demi Vmon, and 1 Upamon. The Demi Vmon is quite self-explanatory because you do want to have jamming draw, and the other one is going to be a draw. So this deck does want to draw their pieces out and definitely end the game. Now we do move on to the black deck, which actually I'm the one who piloted it. So this is a black Omi Turbo variant that I have been trying out, and I do quite like it, especially with the Metagororo release in set 5. Now moving to the level 7 of the deck, we do have 3 Zwart, 2 Zwart Defeat, and 1 Outer S. Every Omimon does have its use, especially the Zwart, because the Zwart now allow you to go actually call out bodies which black kind of struggled behind in the previous sets, where they are only able to commit to one big Digimon and the big Digimon doesn't have much impact. The Zwart Defeat is for the cheese out game or actually killing off Tamers if you do have the luxury to do so. And the Outer S is there to actually counter yellow, because you do evolve the Outer S and you are able to clear quite a bit of rookies. Now moving on to the level 6, we do run 4 Metagurumon and 3 Hyandramon. Now the Metagurumon does have a very strong turn passing effect, whereby upon evolving, you're actually able to Digiburst 2 to kill off the 6 cost hardcore below on the opponent's side of the field, and if you do not, you're actually able to kill off their security, which does eliminate the potential of an option or a tamer. Now the Hyandramon is quite questionable after I played that game, because Hyandramon doesn't really do much except evolving to the level 7s, but sometimes you just don't have the level 7s in hand and they do become a 12k breaking Digimon on the field, and I would suggest cutting them out for potentially a War Greymon or a Blitz Greymon, something with a more major impact. Now to level 5s, we do run the much welcome in set 5 card, the 2 cost level 5. They finally came for black and thus allow this deck to actually go for the level 7 turbo. We do play 3 Infomon because Infomon's superior court by the Zwart ability does proc its on-place ability due to Zwart's ruling or rather Zwart's effect. And we do run off, we do conclude the level 5 counts with 2 more Gumamons because we do want to run optimally 9 level 5s as you do want to turbo into the level 7. Now for the level 4s, it's quite interesting. I do play 4 Dark Tyranomon, quite self-explanatory, 4 Lumimon instead of 4 Tangmon. Now Lumimon, because it's a 3 cost hardcore and having a level 4 on the field, you are able to cheat out to the Metagurumon, because Metagurumon does activate its ability by Digibursting 2, so minimally you do need to have a level 4 in a Digisource. And for the next 4 level 4s, we do play 2 Sealdramon mainly because of a 6k blocker and 2 Babungamon. Now Babungamon is actually a flex tag and I would take it out after what happened in that tournament. Basically, this card was actually meant to chase out a potential blocker because it does de-evolve for 7 costs below, but most of the times opponent will be hiding nursery, so making this card quite useless, and you usually do not want to push your level 4 Digimon out of the nursery, leaving them vulnerable to your opponent. Now to round off in the rookie, we do play 4 Chumon, which is the mouse. Now this mouse actually stops opponent from gaining memory, which does do its job against Hexablomons, Patamons, and even D-Brigade matchups, because of the Dark Drummon is not able to actually gain that 10 memory when they do place a 5 D-Brigade on top of the deck. And next we do run Foil Torgumon with the ability, the inherent ability from the trial deck that allows you to draw one if the opponent did not swing. This is actually quite good in certain matchups, because some matchups they do not actually swing early, and having them allowing you to draw deeper into your deck does is always welcome basically. And we do run 6 rookies here, the Vanilla Rookies, because Vanilla Rookies are just one of the best card, or rather undervalued card, or rather underestimated card in the game, because they are just good bodies and memory efficient. And to round the whole deck up is we are running 2 Tamers, Easy Izumi Tamers and not the Taichi Tamers, because Easy Izumi does have the Luck Sack factor in the option, in a security whereby when it does come out, you are able to review the top 3 to actually gain that one memory during opponent's turn. Now finally, for the Digitamas, quite straightforward will be the 4 reboot plus 1k Digitama, which does work well with the Metal Guru Mons, which does make it 12k. And lastly, that last Digitama that gains memory when your level 7 attacks, because there's no other better black Digitama in my opinion. Now thank you for watching till the end, and do consider subscribing if you haven't subscribed already, and drop a like and a comment if you do enjoy the content.